Hello and welcome back to the Swiss Crypto Podcast. I am Smiles and in today's episode, we are going to talk about IBM's Cobalt tracing blockchain. So stay tuned and let's get into it. You can't predict the future, but your supply chain can be ready for it. That's the slogan that IBM uses to announce their blockchain supply chain solution. Now, in today's episode, I want to have a closer look at how IBM is implementing blockchain in one of the very important sectors, the supply sector. And for that, we can have a look at IBM's official internet site, where they even have a section called IBM Blockchain. And to start from the real beginning, for those that don't know what IBM really is, IBM, or International Business Machines Corporation, is an American multinational information technology company, one of the biggest around the world, with approximately, if I have it in mind correctly, $77 billion in revenue, and it's leading in a lot of sectors, especially in the computer hardware, middleware, and software sectors. And as one of the biggest companies around focusing on that topic, IBM also is focusing a part of their company power to a topic that all concerns us in the end, that is blockchain technology, the underlying technology that keeps Bitcoin working, that keeps all the cryptocurrencies working. And as you probably know, blockchain can not only be used as an underlying technology for cryptocurrencies, it can also be used as a way of storing data in different ways, maybe for a supply chain, maybe for tokenization of different assets, and so on. And IBM wanted to try out using blockchain, their own IBM blockchain, with a project that they call IBM Cobalt Tracing. And that topic is not a very new topic. They actually published on their own website. You can have a look at the link down below in the description. They published that article on their own site last January 2019. So that's over a year ago. But what I think is very important about this is that one of the biggest companies around is focusing also on blockchain technology, pretty sure also on cryptocurrency if it deals with hardware, software, computer stuff. And I just wanted to talk about this topic because it concerns one sector where blockchain could be implemented in the future or will be implemented in the future for sure, and that's the supply chain sector. And a supply chain is basically just a chain where you can follow the way that a product has gone. Maybe coconut oil in your store where you can scan a QR code and see on the blockchain where it's already been or what it's been through, or maybe another asset. And in this case, in IBM's case, they launched a pilot with the IBM Cobalt Tracing. And in that pilot, they want to tackle the ethical cobalt production problem. The thing is that cobalt is used in a lot of different industry sectors, a lot of different technology sectors. It's been used for smartphones, enabling electric vehicles to go into the mainstream production. It's used in lithium-ion battery technology, renewable energy storage, battery technology, and so on and so on. So cobalt is really used a lot and is needed a lot also to keep up our standard of living. But there is a problem with getting that cobalt, as it exists for several other fine metals. And IBM says it in their own words. How do we ensure these benefits are not offset by the ethical, social, and environmental risks associated with the production, trade, and transformation of materials critical to this battery technology? At the heart of this challenge is cobalt. Cobalt once was seen as a byproduct of copper mining process, but has seen its demand and price skyrocket in recent years due to its critical stabilizing role in lithium-ion batteries. Approximately two-thirds of global cobalt production happens in the Democratic Republic of Congo, the DRC, which also has a significant part of global production in copper, as well as tin, tantalum, tungsten, and gold. In the DRC's industrial mining sector, environmental and social risks are reality. The small-scale mining operations in cobalt, copper, and 3TG that dot the vast country and sustain the livelihoods of approximately 2 million people are often beset with profound challenges, including human rights violations, as well as conflict financing. Now, breaking the article up here, from what you've heard, it's a well-known problem. I'm pretty sure you already heard of that problem with other goods, maybe with palm oil mowing down the whole Amazon, or with blood diamonds that are being produced, if you want to say so, in mines with really unethical standards. And for IBM, it also is a problem with these cobalt mines. And to implement blockchain in a supply chain, they started a pilot where they want to trace where cobalt is coming from, where it's going to, and what stages it goes through. And to that they say, starting with cobalt and the battery metal supply chain, this is the challenge we are trying to address in a new responsible sourcing blockchain pilot being delivered in collaboration among IBM, Ford, LG Chem, Huayou Cobalt, and RCS Global. As a group, we represent the major stages of a typical cobalt supply chain, from a mine in the DRC, refining and upgrading in Asia, and to an end user in the United States or Europe. So you guys get the sense behind all this effort. They want to track really what is happening with that resource, how it gets treated, how the people are treated that are getting that resource out of the ground for our everyday technology. And I know this cryptocurrency space is more focused on currencies, not that focused on the underlying technology of blockchain. We all are here to try to make some money, to get some money out of this cryptocurrency space, me myself too, but I do think it's also very interesting and important to understand the benefits that the underlying technology of cryptocurrencies, that is blockchain, brings to our everyday life. And this is just one application of it, and it's being used by one of the biggest companies. So that just shows how big the adoption is around the world. That was in 2019, January 2019. We are now already a year further in time, and I'm pretty sure there have been a lot of other big companies using projects like that. Now, what can we as retail investors in mainly cryptocurrencies get out of this, and why should it be interesting to us, you probably ask yourself. For that, IBM writes, once we have completed the pilot with Cobalt, our aim is to then create an open, industry-wide blockchain platform to validate the full range of raw materials used in consumer products and expand the network so that a wider range of participants can join to enable greater responsibility in commodities sourcing. Well, you're still thinking, where do I get my benefit from? Let me tell you, I'm not an expert in all of this. I tell that all the time, always do your own research. But I think adoption is key when it comes to cryptocurrencies. A lot of people still have the misconception that Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies are for criminal purposes or are used only for criminal stuff. And that's certainly not the case. And adoption like this, even if it's only the blockchain technology, the underlying technology for our cryptocurrencies, brings the cryptocurrencies closer to the everyday people. If IBM starts to launch an open industry-wide blockchain platform. People will meet that technology in stores when they want to buy stuff related to technology like smartphones and so on, where you can check where your Cobalt came from, where your smartphone really came from, where the components have been made, and so on. And that will all be on a blockchain platform. And you will know that as a consumer that this technology is called blockchain. And if you get a closer look at what the technology really offers, you will probably also get to cryptocurrencies and will see that Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies are not really the devil, are not only used for illegal stuff, and do have a lot of potential also for everyday people. Now, that's been it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed the content I provided, even if it was a bit a mix between some actual use of the blockchain technology and some adoption case probably in the future for cryptocurrencies. If you enjoyed it, please give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. That would mean a lot to me and helps the YouTube algorithm. And I'll see you in the next one.